want to be really simple. There is a virus, it's spread really easily, and it's okay to be scared. Here's what we can do about it. Recommending to families is, before we even start the conversation with our children, taking a minute to think about how we are doing, because kids really read our nonverbals, and so they're watching us. And so it's important that we process how we feel, maybe with a trusted family friend or a colleague, and then talk to them. So that way we kind of have gotten out our worries. And then we want to be really age appropriate. With younger kids, we're going to use simpler, more concrete terms. With older kids, we can answer some of their more in-depth questions. But we want to focus more on matter of facts and not statistics or the scary evidence. Kids sometimes hear a lot, but they might misconstrue it just given their age level. And so opening up that conversation by saying, tell me what scares you about COVID, or what have you been hearing, or what are you thinking about, or what are you worried about? That lets the child tell you what they've been thinking, and then you can kind of fill in those gaps too. At the end, you might want to even say, what have you heard me tell you today, to make sure we didn't get misunderstood. I think we want to be really simple. There is a virus. It's spread really easily, and it's okay to be scared. Here's what we can do about it. And so talking through the things that they can do to be part of the process to keep people healthy. We can stay indoors as much as possible. We can wash ourselves really well, wash our hands, wash our door handles. But we also want to make sure we focus on helping others too. So we're going to buy things to keep us safe, and we're going to drop off some toilet paper at our neighbors. And so that lets them feel really connected to this community, and it makes it feel a little bit less scary.